knows he's a loser. There's no question about that. People know it. People that know her know it. And I assumed that it was over. She got beaten up pretty badly, and then she wrote a blog. Now, she didn't mention my name at all because she's gutless. But she's a person that, frankly, Barbara Walters, you know, she resurrected her. And I will tell you this, Barbara is not thrilled about it because I spoke with Barbara. Barbara is not a fan of Rosie. That I can tell you.
But
now, I don't think Barbara's going to admit that.
Yeah, publicly,
but Barbara is not a fan of Rosie.
Publicly, Barbara Walters has put out a statement basically saying that she's a friend of yours, but that she likes having Rosie on The View. You think that's not the case?
Well, what else is she going to say? And Rosie will fail with The View just like she's failed with everything else. In all fairness, Rosie got thrown off the air with her other show because she got poor ratings, and you're doing very well in your ratings, so congratulations. But Rosie's ratings were not good, and then she had a magazine which was a total catastrophe. In fact, a rising star, the head of that whole publishing company, ended up losing his job over Rosie the magazine. It was a total failure. So Rosie was down and out, and Barbara resurrected her, at least for a little while. But Rosie will fail. I mean, Rosie's got a death wish. She is not a smart person. I know Rosie.
What do you mean she's got a death
wish? This is not a woman with intellect. Excuse me?
What do you mean she's got a death wish?
Well, I think she's got a death wish. I think Rosie will fail at whatever she does because ultimately she's got a death wish. That's my theory on Rosie.
You're probably not a big reader of her blog, but I just want to read a poem or part of a poem that she put on, which has sort of sparked this all up again. She sort of compares you to a pimp. She says, remember the 70s, a young girl in New York City meets a pimp. He cons her into a life of illusion. She works for him. Do you think she's calling you a pimp?
Well, she certainly is, and she shouldn't be doing that because that could cost her a lot of money. But the fact is that what I did and how this all started is I own the Miss USA pageant and the Miss Universe pageant. The Miss USA has had problems. Rather than getting rid of her, which a lot of people, frankly, wanted me to do, including Rosie, I gave her a second chance. She's right now in rehab, and I gave her a second chance. So instead of saying to this young woman who's in the very formative years, I said, hey, I'm going to give you, life is about second chances, I'm going to give you a second chance. Rosie went crazy. Now, I guarantee you, Rosie would have given her a second chance, but for other reasons. Rosie went crazy. And this is how it all started. It is totally ridiculous. But I really think Rosie has some real problems.
I want to play for the one or two people on the planet who didn't see this or haven't seen it subsequently, what Rosie originally said after the Tara Conner press conference. Here's what she said on The View.
He's the moral authority. Left the first wife, had an affair, left the second wife, had an affair, had kids both time, but he's the moral compass for 20-year-olds in America.
Was it that comment, or was it her false allegations that you've declared bankruptcy multiple times?
Well, you know, it's sort of interesting. I never declared bankruptcy, and like everybody else in the early 90s, I had difficulty, but I never went bankrupt. She said I did. I'm on the cover last month of the Forbes 400. I'm the cover boy of the Forbes 400 rich list, and I don't care about that, except it just shows what a liar she is. She said I went bankrupt. She talks about moral, which was false. She talks about moral compass. I mean, look at Rosie. Look at where she comes. Have you ever seen a comedy act, which is, by the way, terrible? I was at one of her comedy acts, and most of the people left because she was so disgusting. Not funny and disgusting. So, you know, Rosie shouldn't be talking. I mean, the one I feel sorry for in the whole thing is her girlfriend, Kelly. Anybody that has to kiss Rosie, I feel very sorry for.
Rosie, in this new poem, she's also very critical of beauty pageants, calling them, and I quote, where women were paraded around, judged valuable or not by old white men.
And if you look like Rosie, you'd be critical of beauty pageants, too. Believe me. Rosie is a very unattractive woman, both inside and out. And as hard as it is to believe, inside is probably uglier than outside, and that's really saying something. But you have to understand, I know Rosie. Rosie's a loser. Rosie's been pulling the wool over people's eyes for a long time. She is a stone-cold loser. What she is a bully. Rosie says a lot of negative things about a lot of people. Nobody, they don't do anything about it. I did something about it. Rosie is not a talented person, Anderson, and I think I've exposed that. I hope I have.
How much of this is just for publicity? I mean, on her part or on your part?
On my behalf, I will tell you nothing. The Apprentice comes on January 7th. The show, as you know, does very well. It gets very high ratings. I don't need Rosie to help me with my ratings. She probably needs me to help her with her ratings, But I don't need Rosie to help me with my ratings.
But you're not really going to sue her, though. I mean, most legal experts we've talked to say there's probably not that much of a case.
No, my lawyers. Hey, Anderson, I'm a very rich guy. It doesn't matter.
I've heard that.
It doesn't make any difference. I'm a very, very rich guy. For Rosie to say I went bankrupt three times when I never went bankrupt at all, I never went bankrupt. And she said, I mean, you're not allowed to do that. For Rosie to call me a pimp, I'm a pimp. And you know why I'm a pimp? Because I own a beauty pageant. That's why she says I'm a pimp. I'm a pimp because, unlike her, I gave a girl a second chance. That's why I'm a pimp. You're not allowed to make statements like that, Anderson.
You've been really tough in some of your comments. I mean, saying she's a loser, commenting on her weight. Why attack so hard?
I'm not running for office. I don't have to be politically correct. I don't have to be a nice person. Like, I watch some of these weak-kneed politicians. It's disgusting. I don't have to be that way. Rosie is an unattractive person. Rosie is she's a slob. And, you know, how she gets this girlfriend, I don't know. But I look forward to the day that Kelly leaves her. Because Kelly, if you're listening, Kelly, and I'm sure you are, you can do much better.
Is some sort of rapprochement between you two possible?
Are we going to see you on The View?
Anderson,
I have no interest in Rosie. Rosie is a stone-cold loser, resurrected temporarily by Barbara Walters. She will fail. She may pull Barbara down with her, but she will fail. She'll go off. She'll do something that's so insane that I believe that Rosie has some serious mental problems. That's my feeling.
Why do you think so many people find this fascinating? I mean, Maureen Dowd wrote about it in the Times this weekend.
Maureen Dowd is a great woman who does, I think she's, you know, I've been reading her, and she was very nice to me. And to be honest, it started with a beauty pageant contestant. And frankly, she's a great beauty. Tara is a great beauty. So you have beauty, and then you have Rosie, the beast. You have beauty and the beast. So it works well. And then you have Trump. So it's like a good combination of events. But the fact is that it started very simply without Rosie. She interjected herself into this. A very big story was the Miss USA story, whether or not she was going to be terminated. And then the exact opposite of Miss USA in terms of, look, Rosie O'Donnell, you can't look worse than Rosie. She interjected herself into Miss USA, which is sort of hard to believe, and all of a sudden it went from the Miss USA, which was the monster story of the week, to Rosie and Donald Trump, which became the monster story of the week. So, you know, I don't know. She interjected herself in, but I finished it. I mean, I've exposed her for what she is. She's a bully. She's a woman with not a lot going for her. And, you know, the one thing I respect about Rosie, if you have that little going for you, to be even moderately successful like she is hard to believe. I give her credit for that.
Would you go on The View and shake hands with her?
No, I don't want to go on The View. I've been on The View many times. It's frankly not a show that does very good ratings. I mean, unfortunately, the only problem I have is I bring up the ratings of The View. This whole thing brings up the ratings of The View. I have no intention of going on The View. Why would I go on The View?